know how to edit.
Show me.
What's up, guys? So let's say you've just taken a trip or you've got a bunch of footage and you've never edited a video before. Where do you get started? Well, I'm gonna give you a quick crash course on editing. We're gonna go over these 10 basic editing topics, and by the end of it, you'll have learned the most basic fundamentals in editing to get you started on your first project. Now, I'm gonna use Filmora because it's my go-to software, but these techniques I share with you are universal, so you can use them on most other softwares. If you do decide you want to use Filmora, then you can try it free by clicking on the link here or in the description box below. So to start this video off, I'm going to show you a little sample of a travel video that I put together. There are so many things that you can create for video. Now, I would describe my video as a travel and montage film. Now, earlier I mentioned how the editing techniques in this video are universal to most software out there. They're also universal to all types of film genres, such as narrative, music videos, documentaries, and much more. So don't worry if you're not making a travel film. Now, let's take a look at Filmora. When you open Filmora, a window will pop up. Here you can pick the aspect ratio and the mode. Most modern day cameras and phones film video in 16:9 widescreen, so I'll select that. For this tutorial, we will be using the full feature mode in Filmora. In this mode, you can have total control of your edit and full access of the features in Filmora. Now I'll give you a quick tour of the Filmora program. The top left of Filmora is where your media file browser is. This is where you can import and store your files. To the right of this window is the preview screen, where you can preview files in your media browser and where you view your work in the timeline. This long portion on the bottom is called the timeline. This is where your clips will be once you start editing them. The icons above your timeline are your editing tools. You will use these tools to edit your footage in the timeline. Lastly, the icons above the editing tools are links to your media, music, text, transitions, and more features that come with the program. Now, since you know how to use Filmora, let's get started. The first thing I do when starting a video is import my video files, because you need video files to edit your video. After you've opened Filmora, the first thing you'll do is import your media. To do that, press the import media icon. Find your clips, select them, then press load. All your clips will then appear in the same window as the import media icon. For my travel video, I wanted my first clip to be visually interesting and distinctly Japanese. I suggest when you're editing your videos that the first few clips be interesting and set the tone and theme for your video. That's why I chose the samurai shot, but it's really up to you. Now let's get that first clip of yours in the timeline. Take the clip you want in your video and drag it to the timeline. If you want to shorten or lengthen the clip, you can do so by dragging either the right or left side of the clip in the timeline. There is also the split tool. To use the split tool, first find where you want the clip to start, and then do a split. Then find the spot where you want the clip to end, and do another split. Then delete the parts you don't want. Once you start adding clips to your timeline, you'll have cuts. Now let's start going over the most basic technique in editing. Cuts. The first cut I'm going to talk about is the match cut. The match cut is similar to the standard cut, which is just a regular cut. But what makes it different is when one shot is cut to another and matched by the action, same shape, or subject matter. Like this. Now what I've done to this shot is cut on action. A cut that happens on the middle of the action. This cut is often constructed from two clips, not the same clip. Doing a cut on action will make cuts appear smoother or faster. Also, a cut on action can be applied to any level of action, even for something as simple as snapping. Now I'm going to add a little more to the timeline and use standard, cut on action, and match cuts. See you in 5 seconds. Alright, so that just about covers cutting. Now I do have to mention that there are many more cuts, such as the cross cut, that aren't in this video. So as I watch more of this video, I'm getting kind of tired of all these standard cuts, and I feel like I can add more to this video. So to liven it up, let's explore Filmora's effects and tools. Transitions are usually used to change the look of a cut. However, I like to have a reason why I use them, such as having a more serene feeling between cuts. I remember this forest being very peaceful, and right after, I went to the Inari Shrine. I felt a standard cut would be too abrupt, so to smoothen it out, I added a transition called a dissolve. To view the transitions, click the icon that has two arrows pointing away from each other. To add a transition to your sequence, you can either drag it between two clips, or put the scrubber in between two clips, then click the plus sign on your desired transition. Easy, right? Now the cut between the two shots dissolve into each other, which is more pleasing. Now for this skateboarding clip, I want to do something cool. I only want a certain moment of this clip to be in slow motion. This is where the split tool in combination with the speed control function comes in. First, I'm going to find the spot where I want the clip to be in slow motion. I'll then make a split and leave that part as is for now. For the other part of the clip, I just split. I will change the speed by using the edit tool. In the speed section, use the sliding bar to change the speed by making it either slower or faster. In my case, I filmed in slow motion, so I will speed it up. Sometimes I'll cut two clips that have a similar visual aesthetic right after one another, as it eases us into the next shot, like this. What you may not have noticed is that I actually used an overlay to smooth out the cut. The original footage didn't really cut as well as I'd liked, so instead of using a transition, I added an overlay effect to give it a more smooth cut. To add an overlay, select the overlays icon, which is located under the media window. Click on any of them and you can preview it. Once you find one you like, press the plus icon to add it to your timeline. I do want to mention that overlays aren't only for transitioning between two cuts. They're actually meant for being put on top of your footage and giving them a little more flair. On my trip, the food tasted so heavenly, but the raw footage just didn't do it justice. So when I feel like the raw footage could look even better, I take a journey through the filters. So to make the food look more heavenly, I wanted to find a nice glow filter to add to my footage. The filters are located to the left of the overlays. Click on any of them to preview. Just make sure the scrubber is on the clip you want to preview. To apply it to my edit, I'll press the good old plus sign. Filters can easily add drama, change the tone of the shot, or stylize your image. Now if you're wondering the difference between a filter and an overlay, well, a filter generally manipulates your footage, like the color, the contrast, the exposure, and overall image, whereas an overlay simply goes on top of your footage. This is my favorite part of editing, adding music. They say that audio and sound make up 50% of a video. Luckily for me, Filmora comes with a library of music. To see the music library, select the music icon. You can preview songs by clicking them and then pressing play in the preview window. To add a song, just click the plus sign and it will be added to your timeline. We're all humans and sometimes we make mistakes. On occasion, I've set my camera to the wrong white balance setting, which results in the color of my footage just not looking right. Luckily, I can use the color correction tool to fix my mistake. Now, color correction is when you correct the brightness, the darkness, the color temperature, or saturation of your footage. And it generally comes at the last part of the process when you're happy with your edit. Notice how the shot has a blue tint to it. This is because I had my camera's white balance set incorrectly. My camera was set for indoor lighting when it's supposed to be set for outdoor lighting. If the white balance was set correctly for outdoor lighting, it would look warmer. To fix the color of this clip, I'm going to use the Advanced Color Tuning tool. When selected, a window will pop up. In this window, you can use presets or adjust the color on your own. On the left side of this window are the tools and presets you can use, and on the right is where you can preview the changes to the clip you have made. The changes you make in this window will only be applied to the clip you select, not the entire timeline. To adjust the color on this clip, I'm going to use the white balance slider. Since the temperature of this video is a little cold and blue looking, I'll shift the temperature bar more towards the orange section to make it warmer. I just want to correct the footage to look less blue, so I won't have to go too far. Also, when correcting the color of a clip, my rule of thumb is to make the whites look white. If there is no white in the clip, try to find where it's really bright and adjust until it's white. Like the fur of this monkey. Even though I only fixed the white balance in my clip, you can do a lot more with the advanced color tuning tool. You can apply LUTs, use presets, adjust the exposure, add a vignette, and get more out of color correcting. Adding text is a way to make a clear statement of what your video is about. But for me personally, I think keeping it short is the key. To add a title in Filmora, click the text credit icon. Let's pick this one. And to add it to your timeline, click the plus sign. To edit the title, double-click it in the timeline, and the title inspector will pop up. In the inspector window, you can select which text you want to change by double-clicking it. Since I traveled to Japan this year, I'll keep it simple and title it Japan. For the subtext, I'll put the year, which is 2017. Once you're happy with it, it's time to export it. On the very right of the Filmora effects icons is the export button. Click the button and a window will pop up. In this window, you can name your video, select the resolution, and choose where it will save to. For file format, I usually choose MP4, as it's the best codec for uploading to YouTube. Once you're ready, click export, and your video will start exporting. As you can see, Filmora has a bunch of great features and are very easy to do. I have to say, we just scraped the surface of editing concepts, and there are a lot more tools to explore in Filmora. Hope you learned something and that this tutorial helped you get started on editing your next video. Now go ahead and leave us a comment below and let us know what your favorite cut is. Or if you made anything in Filmora, share it with us. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you next time. As a last note, I'm going to leave you with this piece of advice. I believe that great editing is editing that no one notices.